Hi, I'm Scott Taylor, the President of the Students for Independence here in St Andrews. If you want to get involved in the campaign for Scottish independence, then email us at Stausfi, S-T-A-U-S-F-I, at St Andrews, or email me personally, SBT2 at St Andrews. And we've got a great society. We're doing a lot of campaigning before the independence referendum, so please get in contact with us if you can. It's an interesting one. I was asked to say why I'm voting yes. I was never inclined until maybe a year ago to actually want Scottish independence. I've always wanted to sort of create something of a social democracy here in Scotland or Britain. And as such, I joined the Labour Party when I was 18 or 19 when I was a student in Glasgow. I soon realised that the Labour Party was no longer really a vehicle for fundamental change in our society. So I became convinced that the Westminster system is just completely unreformable. The society that I want to see created in Scotland just can't be realised through Westminster. I was then for a while in favour of federalism, or what is now called Devo Max, for Scotland and the other nations and regions in the UK. So essentially everything apart from defence and foreign affairs would be devolved to the nations and regions in the UK. So why am I voting yes? I just want, you know, something of a social democracy in Scotland where kids can have grow up and have an equal chance to prosper in life, where inequality in land ownership and wealth and income and health indicators as well isn't as grossly unequal and as bad as it is at the moment. In Scotland, if we vote yes, do we have the opportunity to create that better society? We have been voting, you know, much more progressively than other parts of the UK for quite a few decades, and there does seem to be a consensus here in Scotland about sort of the necessity to keep elements of the welfare state and public services, such as, you know, free tuition for students, free personal care, free prescriptions, and so on, that the Holyrood Parliament in different governments has protected. I also think that the changes to the welfare system, such as the bedroom tax, wouldn't have been made under an independent Scotland or under Holyrood. So that's why I'm voting yes, to create the social democracy that I'm just completely convinced that we cannot get under the current Westminster system.
Hi, my name's James Rampersad. I'm a physicist. I've never done politics before, and I've never been interested in politicians or any political party. I'm here because this independence referendum will affect everybody in Scotland, and especially everybody at this university, which relies heavily on funding and attracting high-quality academics. As Professor Louise Richardson said, if this independence referendum turns out to be a yes, it will be catastrophic for our university, and will lead to a huge reduction in the amount of funding that the university gets from the Research Council of the UK. And if that were to happen, then the high quality academics would we would fail to attract them, and this would lead to decreasing the amount of research we produce and a reduction of our ranking globally in terms of our academic quality as a university. Professor Jim Naismith, head of biomedical sciences at St Andrews, said there will be a drift away of expertise. It will start slowly, but there will be a clear drift. It's not just the people who leave. We won't be able to bring people in from the outside. Now, he's not biased. He's a member of our university. He's interested in research. He's not a politician. He didn't say this because he wants to benefit one party or the other. He wants to help the university. So I think that we should listen to him, and we should all go out and vote no, thanks, tomorrow. If we vote yes, we're in an extremely difficult situation. The economics just doesn't add up. Scotland currently gets £1,200 more funding per head of population than the rest of the UK average through the Barnett formula. Now imagine taking that away, along with other sources of funding from UK Research Council, the UK Arts and the UK Arts Council. Now imagine the thousands of businesses that move south, taking jobs, investment with them. And now think of the huge startup costs that Scotland would face, installing embassies around the world, building government IT systems, an independent defence force, a new tax authority, intelligence agencies. Combine that with an ageing population and declining oil revenues. £3 billion less than the most pessimistic forecast over the last 2 years. Scotland will be sent spiralling into an economic catastrophe, and for what? So far, the only argument I've heard is to get rid of the Tories. So the Yes campaign is willing to destroy the whole country to get rid of a party that will most likely be out by the next election anyway. It's absolutely ridiculous. I just want to say to anyone who wants to keep St Andrews as a high quality university, which is outputting high quality research and high quality academics, and who wants to maintain a strong United Kingdom, please go down and vote no thanks tomorrow. And if you can spare a bit of time, please help the Better Together campaign with their volunteering. They need people to stand outside and hold signs and just basically to show support to people who come to vote no thanks, and to offset the intimidation which will be inevitably be there by the Yes campaign and the SNP. So please, if you can, help. We need all the help we can get right now. Thank you.